Loyola Law Professor Jessica Levinson joins us this morning to take a closer look at all that's going on. Good morning. Thanks so much for joining us. So President Trump raised $4 million last night in Beverly Hills, and he says he thinks he can actually win California. What's the chance of that really happening?
I think extremely low, and then maybe subtract 10 from that extremely low, and you have the actual chance of him winning California. Mm-hmm. Look, there are Republican voters in California, but even a number of those Republican voters are not Trump supporters. He will certainly get a percentage of the vote here, but I think the chance that he would get all of the electoral votes from California is extremely slim.
Okay. Well, first he was closing the border. Now he's giving Mexico a year to fix the problem. The president has done something similar with health care, and it seems the president pushing off some of his biggest initiatives until after the election. Is that really a good idea?
Well, I think that what we've seen from President Trump is that he is playing to his base. And for his base, I think that this actually is a smart move. The question is, though, what happens, as always, and you've heard me say this before, to the swing voters in the swing states? Mm-hmm. And I think if you look at voters on both sides of the aisle, they unsurprisingly really care about health care, and they want to know what's going to happen to their health care. If you think about what affects people in their daily life, can I pay my medical bills? Are my kids going to get a good education? What's going to happen in terms of my being able to pay for my house, my taxes, etc.? So I think it's a risky move, but to the extent that he was going to put forward an unpopular proposal, it's a good move, at least for his base.
Okay. Well, the Democrats have subpoenaed the president's tax returns. Is the law on their side, would you say?
So the Democrats are using a provision of the tax code that says that there are three different committees, and the chairs of those committees can ask for any filer's information. And the president is, in fact, any filer. Mm-hmm. And so if you look at the plain language of the tax code, I think it absolutely indicates that they have the power to look at those filings. And again, it's in a closed executive session, so there's nothing to indicate that the taxes would then become public. The president has already responded last week, and he said, but you need a legitimate legislative purpose, and essentially this is just a witch hunt. He's also said, well, I'm the president, you need to treat me differently, I have different privacy concerns. My sense is that the Supreme Court may be the final word on this particular issue.
Wow, okay. And on to Joe Biden. So he's continued to take some criticism, but he did make this video to try to clarify what's been happening. Do you think that it's enough?
I don't think for the people who really are invested in Me Too, who are thinking about what the movement really means, I think that Joe Biden's comments have shown, frankly, that he's a bit out of step with where we are right now. He, in his first public appearance since the accusations came out, he made a number of jokes saying, I have permission to hug this person. Oh, this person gave me consent to touch them. Funny, but kind of missing, I think, what's important about the movement. Mm-hmm. And he really has all but said that he's running. I mean, these speeches, I think, are really the beginning of his campaign. He said, lawyers have told me I have to be careful. I can't trigger certain words. He has great name recognition, mm-hmm. great fundraising prowess. He's run for president before and never been successful, but never as the former vice president. Mm-hmm. So I don't think that he's gaining traction in particularly the younger voters, mm-hmm. but that may not be needed considering who votes in solid numbers in primary elections.
Time will tell when that announcement's coming as well. All right, Jessica, thank you so much for your
time.
We appreciate it.